Is it okay now? Is the stream working okay? Can everyone hear me okay? I hate advertisements. It's back, yeah. So, can everyone hear me all right? Okay, good. Yeah, I don't know what the hell happened. I mean, it suddenly crashed for no good reason. So I don't really know what the hell happened. But hopefully we won't get interruptions like that again. Dusty, wait, weren't you split up into a bunch of parts? Enigma, ever thought of living in Vermont or Massachusetts? The states are known to be the most liberal in the US. 32% in Massachusetts has no religion. I don't know. I mean, like, even if they are liberal, I don't know if that would like benefit me as an individual. Because, you know, like, okay, let's say they're liberal states. Like, how would that help me as a private citizen? You know, no matter what, I'm still stuck with no health insurance, as far as I know. Unless I, you know, get it through a job that I happen to find there, right? So, you know, a lot of progressive actions need to be taken on the federal level. You know, it's. I don't know if it's good enough that just the individual state is liberal. Just because people are liberal too doesn't mean they aren't racist. That's also very true, yeah. Plenty of white liberals who are racist. Yeah, I mean, look at fucking Thunderfoot and The Amazing Atheist. Like, okay, I mean, you could say that they aren't overtly racist, but they're at least, I mean, they're suffering from a horrible case of white privilege, at least. Find all of Dusty. Whoops. Yeah, so they decided to take my powers away again. This is, I mean, it changes up the gameplay a little bit, I guess, but I can't say I really like it. Yeah, by the way, Marky Mark, the racist, you know, Mark Wahlberg, he was from Massachusetts, you know? I don't know about The Amazing Atheist, what do you mean? He's anti-feminist, I know that much. Used to listen to his streams ages ago. I was never a fan. I never understood why anyone even liked that guy. I never understood, like, what did he contribute to the rational skeptic community at all? And then he stopped to talking about atheism related stuff and then just went to talking about anti-feminism stuff. I found his commentary to be the most sane at the time. How was he sane? He was he once made a, like, here's the thing, I have my criticisms of the police, but his, like, criticism of the police was one of the most nonsensical things I've ever seen. You know, he said he opposes police not because they beat people up or because they are sometimes racist or because they are have a culture of corruption or because so-called good cops protect bad cops. No, he opposes police because of intrinsically they're supporting the will of the government or something like that because of the of their essential role in upholding the law, and therefore their sycophants of the law. I can't even remember what exactly he said, but it was words to that effect, and it was just the most nonsensical thing. Yeah, we need to have agents that are enforcing the laws, because if you don't have agents enforcing the law, then the law effectively doesn't exist. You know? That's why I always criticize people who say, oh, God has laws and God has moral judgments and moral laws. Well, God never enforces his moral laws, so therefore it doesn't matter if he has laws or not, even if you assume he exists. Because if you don't enforce the law doesn't exist. It's still weak, but I think my power's coming back. It'll keep growing if I keep reassembling Dusty. Even if you find the rest of your cat, it won't matter. Michigan and Pennsylvania are the least racist states, according to some source. PA's pretty liberal. I mean, like, Pennsylvania is also one of the whitest states in the country, you know? Like, statistics like that don't really mean a lot to me, because you can find the least racist state is usually the most white, you know? Like, as long as it's very white, then there's not gonna be a lot of racism there. Like, but that's kind of no, that would logically lead to that. You know, as long as you don't have racial diversity, there's not going to be racism because it physically can't exist. Yeah, I mean, like, the only reason why that might be true, nomads, is just because that Pence, if you look, actually, this is what you do, Zaxtor. Look up the racial statistics for Pennsylvania. Pennsylvania is one of the most white states in the entire country. So if it's not racist, that's the reason, because there just isn't any racial diversity there. Even if you find the rest of your cat, it won't matter. New Zealand has lots of white and is one of the least racist country. Well, I mean, like, New Zealand is also the product of, you know, imperialism too, you know. How do the Maori people feel about Europeans taking their country from them? He'll never escape from here. My panther will see to that. Good, good. That's the spirit. I'll be waiting for you to give up. Oh, fuck it. What? What happened? Exactly, Nilavani. Exactly. Georgia has over 3KK blacks, and Georgia has lots of Hicks and is a GOP state. Yeah, you can't go on statistics alone. You know, they don't tell the full story. Yeah. New York is a pretty liberal state, has over 3 million blacks. Yeah. Like, racism, it's difficult to assess racism with just a statistic, you know? because like how do we quantify racism, you know? And we have to take into account the racial diversity of that state in question as well. If the state has a monolithic race that is dominant, you know, it's like 99% white, yeah, it's not gonna have a lot of racism there just because there isn't a lot of racial diversity. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, that was the point I was making, Crimson. You know, you can't really quantify racism. Oh, damn it. And up there as well. Now they can actually do some things. I know states like Louisiana are literally trying to imprison every black person there. Yeah, I mean, just look at what recently happened just now. Another cop got away with murdering a black person in Baton Rouge, Louisiana. You know, like, what will it take for this to end already? Like, how are they able to get away with this over and over again? I don't know. You know, police are supposed to be the ones to protect and serve the people, yet they're the ones who are murdering black people. They're supposed to be protecting them. People don't trust the police now, and for good reason. They see them as the criminals. That Nevi looks like anal beads. I kind of want to get close, but all right. There we go. Strange shapes to them, yeah. They come in all kinds of different shapes and sizes. It seems like any time, like, you know, that there was that one guy that came to the stream once. It seems like any time you have like an enemy that's kind of like shadowy like this, it automatically reminds people of Kingdom Hearts, it seems. Because he was like, oh, this reminds me of Kingdom Hearts. Yeah, because of the enemies. You think that game is the only game to ever have enemies that look like this? New York is divided into people seem to think that New York is just the five boroughs. New York is massive. Yeah, there's upstate. Everyone forgets there's an actual state there above New York City. Yeah, I know, Zax. I mentioned that in one of my videos. That's the last piece of Dusty. I think my power is back too. Something feels different about you, or whatever it is. We work together to take out that panther and get out of here. Oh, you said Belgium. I was thinking of Austria. Austria has some anti-racism laws as well. As does Germany. More of these fuckers? Shit. Jeez. Fucking hell. Invincible when she's taking off the special attack. That's not good. How am I supposed to kill those big fucks? Let's step down. Good. Attack me. Oh, time to wander around. Oh, Jimmy, thanks a lot for the host. Belgium, 1981. Hold on. Okay, good. There's more over there. Many of them. Like, it's damn near impossible to avoid those attacks. Ah, I used the wrong attack. Oh well, this works. What? How did I miss that? These dudes are buff as fuck. Where are they? Oh, there he is. Finally! Here we go. There we go. Go for the finisher? Wait, hold on. Go for the finisher? Against two, though. There we go. Germany has done well for their people. Education is top-notch. Can't say I'm not a little jealous. I wish in New York I could take tests which push me in the right direction. In New York, you take Regents and call it a day. Cool-looking finisher. I missed it. I missed it. I was reading Nomads' comment. What just happened? That was amazing. I just couldn't let sleeping cats lie. You've performed beyond my wildest expectations. But don't think this is the end. Soon all will be revealed. She's naked again. It does not screen your strengths or weaknesses, it just tells them what you managed to copy. Monkey see, monkey do. Yeah. Most tests are like that. Bullshit. I see it's falling to pieces. Still don't know what happened, was real or not. Turn was no dream. Jeez, how the hell did she show up out of nowhere? She just shows up while she's sleeping naked. In Germany, you take a test and it basically tells you what you have the potential for. They push you in that direction when you're done. Okay. So that was mission 20, so I guess just one more mission then. I guess that's it. I find it weird when GOP Hicks calls California Commifornia or something like something, but doesn't call Vermont nor Mass. Those names when they are more liberal. Yeah, I mean, like, probably because of Hollywood and stuff like that. Because stricter anti-hunting laws. I would guess because of Hollywood. Because Hollywood is typically liberal. That would be my guess. And since it's more visible, that's why they deride it more. Finland has really good education, too. Yeah, America has shitty education. I know that much. It is shitty. Let me talk to Cyan. Sania, how can you always be so calm? I can't stop thinking about... I can't stop thinking something bad's about to happen. I wish something good would happen for a change. You're funny. Just think that all bad things are good and nothing but good things will happen. That's one way to think of it. What? That doesn't even make any sense. Yeah, I agree. You just have to go back into your mind and change the memories to make them better. Just try to imagine how you would do things differently and make it so that's what happened. Then all the bad things change to good things. Yeah, it sounds like she's like reciting lines from that stupid book, The Secret, which is like, oh, just think positive thoughts and then positive things will happen. You can't change the past. You only get one shot at it. Everything you remember about the past is all in your head, right? And that's all that matters. You can't do that. You can't do that. You can't change. Your mind is reacting to reality. Unless you're insane, you cannot change the way your brain thinks. Estonia 2 Zax. Estonia 60% forest. Yeah. Nilavani posted some, she posted a photo of Estonia, Estonian forest. She posted two other photos of forest, and I was like, "Is that Estonia?" Then Nilavani was like, "Nope." And then she posted a photo of an Estonian forest. Finland is one of the very few country that doesn't abuse their forest nor overlogging. Finland has almost three-fourths of its forest covered left. I see. If you think something happened, then it did. What the fuck? What is this? She is a horrible philosopher. But there's proof that things happened the way they did. The other people who were with me at the time, things left behind. Well, if you discover a contradiction, you just have to go back to when you discovered it and uncontradict it. Like, what the fuck? Yeah, I'll just pretend like my spouse didn't cheat on me. That'll make everything better. That's nonsense. But then maybe if I thought the nonsense away, it would start to make sense. Yeah, right. Let's just pretend like cops in America aren't murdering black people. Let's just pretend that. And if we just reverse that and make believe that that's a positive thing, then we won't have Black Lives Matter. We won't have to fight for our rights. We won't have to fight for the rights of minorities or for black people. And then everything will be happy-go-lucky. We can just pretend like cops aren't killing people. Except the only problem is that they'll keep on doing that. You see, nothing changes for the better if people don't oppose wrongness. Suriname has a little over 90% of its forest left. Estonia has 61%. Mozambique has around 78% left. Cat, just try it. Look into my eyes and discover your memories again for the first time. Wow, I'm having total deja vu here. I feel like I remembered something like this back when I first met you too. Okay. Nah. Iceland had the best idea to have the most advanced seed bank. Oh yeah, I heard about that. They have I saw a video actually that hey, now she's hanging out in my crib? What the fuck? Yeah, they had a seed bank that looks a lot like wait a minute, hold on. That looked a lot like a nuclear bunker, actually. It was kind of weird. But kind of cool at the same time. Gotta preserve the seeds, man. Yep. Where am I going? Where do I go? Maybe here. It is a bunker. Yeah, it is. Yeah, it is. It basically is. Sweden are one of the lowest in fossil fuel. They have no oil plants exposed to make their car green. Yeah. We need electric cars already. Well, what we need are better batteries. They need to work on that shit. Why are they taking so fucking long? We need to improve our battery technology. Sweden, huh? I'd like to see that. Let's see, where do I go? Maybe here? Okay, wait a minute, hold on. Where do I go for the. Don't know. Is this where I am? We'll just go here. We'll wing it. Why am I not going here? Why am I not go. Oh, because I didn't find any friggin' thing yet. Alright, fine. I'll just do this. Costa Rica became the first country ever to ban sport hunting. So did Israel. So Israel. disputed might become the first fur-free country. Well, they're killing tons of people there, so I mean, like, the fact that they're fur-free, like, hardly matters to me. They're killing tons of Palestinians. You know? Let's see if they ban killing Palestinians in Israel, then I might be impressed. We need to dismantle apartheid. Yeah, they're an apartheid state. They absolutely are. We allow companies to dictate the rules. GOP needs to abolish. The GOP is going to self-destruct because they're divided. I mean, there's people even in the GOP that are sick of, you know, all the racists in their own political party. But, you know, what do you expect? That political party was founded on racism. The only reason why I shouldn't say founded on racism, but the modern incarnation of it was founded on racism. It was founded by taking advantage of white Southerners' racism towards black people. That's it. Trump said Trump will be the fallen of GOP. He said Trump will make GOP fall. The Southern strategy, right?
The infamous Southern strategy.
Trump or Hillary, I don't believe in none of them. Yeah. Yeah. I mean, they used the Southern strategy to try and get Southerners on board with their party, and it worked. I want a woman president, but she's clearly a warmonger. I just want I want a president that's a progressive. I don't care what their gender is. I want a progressive leader. I want someone who's actually gonna do something about healthcare, make it a single payer system. Southern strategy made the so-called silent majority look real. Yeah. I said GOP took off their Halloween costume by revealing that they founded the KKK. Well, back then, I mean, they were Democrat, technically. They were something called Southern Democrat, but yeah, I mean, like, they then joined the Republican Party later on. Let's see. Yeah, let's get this. I think this is good. Alright, so let's go to the last story mission, which is not here. So that's where we go. These were the front lines for the KKK initially. There were KKK members in the police force. You know, there's a really good film. I highly recommend it to you, Zax. And Nilavani, if you haven't seen it yet, you should definitely watch it. You watch Mississippi Burning. It actually stars William Dafoe. It's really, really good. Mississippi Burning. I really like that film. The only criticism that some people made about, and I do agree, is that that movie makes black people look like passive bystanders. You know. And, of course, that's inaccurate. Hey, Big Jixer, what's up, dude? It's in the big part of the city, I believe. Okay. Okay, got it. I saw that film when I was a kid. Yeah, it's a good film. It's a really good film. William Dafoe, who played the Green Goblin in Spider-Man. He was in that movie. Also, William Dafoe was in Platoon. Remember that line in Platoon? You ain't a firing squad, you piece of shit! And then he punches that motherfucker in the face. Remember that scene? I see Mississippi Burning. Yeah, that's a good film. I like that film. Gene Hackman is in it. Yeah, Gene Hackman's in it. But did you see Platoon with William Dafoe? Remember when he goes, "You ain't a firing squad, you piece of shit!" And then he punches that dude in the face. I love that scene. No, he didn't punch him in the face. I think he slapped him. He smacked him with the butt of his rifle. Is this the one? Am I in the right city now? I've been just cruising around looking for the right city. I don't even know if I'm in the right city. I've seen Platoon. That's the one of the few American war movies I like. Yeah. Why do you like Platoon? Oh shit, I'm in the wrong place. Alright. Where do I go? I just went back in a circle. Holy crap. Movie scores 89% on Rotten Tomatoes. Yeah. Ebert gave four stars. I like Platoon. I like Platoon, but I think Apocalypse Now is better. That's my opinion, though. Say in Jack Nicholson's voice, he is Jake's. You gotta say that. That's your name. You gotta do that. Like that whole Vietnam trilogy Oliver Stone did. There's also another good Vietnam War movie with Michael J. Fox and Sean Penn. It's called Casualties of War. Heaven and Earth is the best one. I didn't see that one. I should watch that. You know, the irony is that now Vietnam and America are good buddies, and America is selling weapons to Vietnam. If there wasn't any more evidence of how fucking useless that war was. I mean, and I'm putting aside the immorality of it, the abhorrent war crimes and everything else, just by putting all of that aside. And we're just going based upon utility. That right there demonstrates how fucking useless that war was. And how all those people died in vain for no good reason on both sides. Oh, I missed Nilavani's comment. Rather than a U.S. soldier. William Dafoe was there. Guy who played the crazy psycho in Speed 2 Cruise Control. I never saw Speed 2. I heard that movie was bad. I saw Speed 1. I like Speed 1. Heaven and Earth is the best Vietnam War film because it is in the perspective of a Vietnamese woman. Okay, I gotta watch that then. Heaven and Earth. Also, I recommend Casualties of War. I saw a clip of that when I was a kid, and I always wanted to see it again. Recently, I saw it. I was able to remember. I was able to find out what the name of that movie was because I knew that Michael J. Fox was in it, so it wasn't hard to find the name of it. But I'm still looking for the name of that movie where the girl and the woman disintegrate that guy in the fucking booth. I don't think I'm ever gonna find that movie. Very depressing. I loved it. Yeah, I know you loved it. I knew that you would love it, Zax. I knew you would love it. Don't even need to tell me that you loved it. I knew that you loved it. It's like, as soon as you mentioned Speed 2 Cruise Control, as soon as you mentioned that, and as soon as I said that everyone else hated it, I knew you loved it. I knew it. All right, where am I going? This is not even the right. This is not the right way. Zax loves it all. As long as it doesn't have animal abuse, or if it isn't inherently racist, then yes, he loves it. All right. So where am I going? See, I gotta go here, Pleasure, I think. Oh no. Damn it, I'm right back where I started. Hold on. All right, I guess I'll just travel through these things until I get to where I'm supposed to be because I really got to go to the part of the city where the woman dropped her letter. Yeah, I can't remember exactly where that was. I guess I'll just travel through these things until I find it eventually. The guy's car gets destroyed by an anchor, and the little dog survive. Grim went to sleep tonight. Yeah, I guess she must have fallen asleep. Yeah, I was talking to her about that earlier today. I mean, it's the time zone difference. I mean, I could stream earlier, but most people. Okay, there it is. Finally found it. Oh, there's Crimson. Yeah, she's just quiet because I'm about to sleep though. Yeah, it sucks being on different time zones for her. I could stream earlier. But most people get off work like around, you know, like 5, and then it takes them some time to get home. And I mean, I can stream earlier. Like, Nilavani, what time do you usually get off work? I mean, you're an hour behind me. So like if we're just an hour earlier. How would that work? Good, what are you doing here? Is Cyania here too? The end is nigh. Are you ready for it? The end? What are you talking about? Afternoons, usually. No, Enigma, just do you, man. Yeah, I know. But I want to be accommodating, too, though, you know? I mean, I'm flexible. Ever saw Under Siege? I saw the two, loved them. She's learning from us. I'm a New Yorker, take notes. Steven Seagal makes a lot of good films. Isn't Steven Seagal... I can't remember if he's a good guy or a bad guy. Steven Seagal, maybe I'm thinking about somebody else. Steven Seagal, doesn't he do like martial arts or something? I can't remember. Call it creator's intuition, but I sense a disturbance in the fabric of reality, as if a great many things were moving towards their conclusion. Steven Seagal is a weirdo. Loves Putin. Really? Ah, oh, fuck Steven Seagal. Putin sucks. He kicks ass. The guy I don't like is that stupid fuck Chuck Norris. I fucking hate Chuck Norris. I was in love with him. I was in love with his movies as a kid. All right, guys, I'm gonna leave the stream on though, so no talking shit about me. No problem, Crimson. Thank you so much for streaming with me. Have a good night. He's an animal rights activist. Okay, that's good. Good luck tomorrow. What's going on tomorrow with Crimson? Does she have something going on tomorrow? Chuck Norris is a racist bigot and an atheist hating bigot. And the funny thing is, Chuck Norris is like half Native American and he totally forgot about his Native American roots. Instead, he embraced his hick side. He's homophobic. Yeah. He became like... He's like a hardcore Christian. Did he forget what happened to his native ancestors by European invaders? Did he just kind of ignore that? Someone message me tomorrow, Enigma or no, on Twitter. Need someone to entertain me on my boring day. Okay, no problem. No problem. I'll drop you a line. He got hickicized. Exactly. That fucking hick. Rip me, no Twitter. You should get Twitter, Nomads. We can all be buddy-buddy on Twitter. Steven Seagal is also a Buddhist. Oh, okay. Well, that's good. But Nilavani says Steven Seagal is a weirdo, so, you know, that's the final judgment from Nilavani. Doesn't matter if he's a Buddhist. As long as he's a weirdo, he's a weirdo. End the story! I don't know, Seagal seems like a scam artist. How's he a scam artist? I mean, I know he's a weirdo, but... What's he scamming people? What's he scamming people with? Chuck took so... back to doing, which is kind of martial arts, I take it. Yeah, I mean, he used to be, like, a fighter, and then he's like, oh, I could have been a Bruce Lee. Bruce Lee wasn't a fighter, I was a professional fighter. It's like, shut the fuck up, Chuck Norris, you dumb hick. Bruce Lee would have kicked his ass. Chuck Norris sucks the big one. He also wrote an open letter to the leadership of Thailand in 2003, urging them to enact a law to prevent the torture of baby elephants. I see. Well, that's good. Seagal referred to Putin as the world's greatest leader. Well, what do you got to say about that, Zax? I mean, Steven Seagal, this is like buddy-buddy, best friends forever with Putin. He rides around in a little Russian motorcycle club with Putin. What the fuck? Him and Putin are tight. What the hell? Oh, what's going on? Shit's going down here. I heard nothing but bad things about him. Maybe he got brainwashed by Putin. Maybe.
Who, Andriux? Don't be silly. You must be thinking of someone else.
Beloved citizens, you are gathered here today to bear witness to history. Today is the day we rid ourselves of the Nevi menace once and for all. Join me in welcoming our new savior. What the heck is that? Their new toy, apparently. Emergency incoming Nevi. Quick, no pushing, women and children first. Perfect timing, wouldn't you say? Gate, I'll be right back. Cat, something's not right. Ladies and gentlemen, what a wonderful opportunity to demonstrate the awesome offensive capability of the latest in military technology, the Sea Enemy. There are sites saying Keanu Reeves is one of the nicest actors in the world. Keanu Reeves, support for charities including PETA, Angelware, and Wildlife. Apparently, according to Nolavani, there's also sites saying Keanu Reeves is an immortal. Is everything ready? Here, see for yourself. He was once kicked out of a music festival in Estonia. Oh, Seagal was. Okay. How embarrassing. Why was he kicked out? Because he was, like, showing off his kung fu and everyone thought he was being, like, a goofball and they said, yeah, get the fuck out of here, Seagal. You're a weirdo. Fucking kung fu master. Get the fuck out of here. Oh, this is episode 20. This is not episode 21. So this is not the last episode yet. Keanu is an ass? In what way? I'd like them in the Matrix.